As early as December 1941, Hitler had ordered that plans be drawn up for the construction of an Atlantic wall to ensure protection of the Atlantic coasts of Europe from attack by sea. Work began in the spring of 1942, and by April of the following year, almost 250,000 conscript laborers were at work on the wall's construction. From the tip of Norway to the Spanish border, every beach was to be made impassable and a line of impregnable fortifications built. To engage warships offshore and to maul the fleets of transports in the event of invasion, naval guns were to be housed in indestructible bunkers. Behind the line, tracks were to be laid for railway guns, many capable of throwing shells as far as England. In the autumn of 1943, Hitler became convinced that an invasion in the West had become inevitable. He ordered Rommel to undertake an inspection of the Atlantic Wall defenses and to prepare for what he believed would be the decisive engagement of Allied and German arms. Believing also that the invasion would be launched across the Straits of Dover against the Pas de Calais, Hitler ordered priority to be given to this sector over other sectors of the front. By mid-1944, the Atlantic Wall was nearing completion only in the sector of the Pas de Calais. In other sectors, it was still far from complete. It was in the incomplete and weakly defended Normandy sector that on June 6, 1944, the Allied invasion was to take place.